these days, clothes cleaning. Like so many good service ideas, the laundrette started in America. The first British one opened in 1949. They were a boon for the vast majority of the population, which then had no washing machines, as well as for richer folk too, who could no longer afford domestic servants.
When you've selected the kind of wash your clothes need, you put in 2 shillings and the washer starts to roll. After a pennyworth in yet another machine to shake off the drips, and 6 pennyworth of drying in this one, the wash is done.
10p for a wash, 2.5p for a dry, I don't know. In their heyday, there were around 8,150 laundrettes in Britain. One of the very early ones was this one in South Kensington. As it happened, I remember it well. I used to be one of the 2,000 people a week who used to use it way back in the 50s and early 60s. Now, though, it's one of only around 3,800 laundrettes left. Its owner, Stanley Bloom, who's even written a book about the history of the laundrette, told me why.
Today, 80% of the homes have washing machines, and we can only cater for that 20% that don't have them, and for people whose washing machines break down, which happens quite frequently, then they come in, but they're just the occasional customers. They are not our bread and butter. And we've got to consider that most of the market's taken up by the home washer. We just have the odd 20-25% of those who do not think it worthwhile to have a home washer.
But laundrettes may soon be on the increase again. Some new style establishments, like this one in Fulham, offer new style services. They'll wash, iron, collect and deliver your laundry for you. In Chalfont St Peter in Buckinghamshire, this one has special lighting, a waitress service coffee bar, piped music and books to read. And author Stanley Bloom thinks laundrettes that offer service, new technology and good management to beat the rising costs of rent, rate and vandalism will ensure that they will live on at least. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.